Hey, Mall Railroaders, this is Southern 207 coming back with another update. Yes, you can actually start to see the main section of layout clear up again. Got a couple tourist motors to reinstall, but that's to be expected from all the damage that was done. Luckily, only one small piece of the track work on the main layout was damaged during the whole move. And what the pain is, that's the only bit I might have a few more pieces of code 70 rail. As you can see, it's about the length of my thumb. So I gotta repair that. But for as long as it's been saying, the track's actually fairly clean. And in case you guys are wondering, I am planning on setting the layout up to run off of solar still. And that, yes, the battery might show it's a little out of date, but hey, I've checked it. Still got 12 volt charge. That's all that matters. I've only got three of those, and they're 7 amp hour batteries. Which, from what it showed on there, at 7 amps constant draw for 20 hours straight. That's how the amp hours works, guys. It's generated over a 10 or 20 hour window. And Rodney, another tank car coming to you. This one has metal wheel sets too. But I'm slowly gathering up odds and ends. I'm still tinkering with capacitors too, guys. Beefy. But just showing we're doing some progress. And also found a couple really old some of my older magazines. Yes, by Constant Publishing. But the surprising thing is, the technique I've been using here for track construction is actually not as old as I initially thought. Anyway, when I find it, I'll post a video on it showing my process. But I've also got another project in the works. Hint, hint. Considering I've already got one, well, actually three of them, which need to be built. But like I said, things are progressing. And hopefully over the next few days I get the last of this knocked out. And this all cleaned off and operating. That's my goal. To get all of this that you're seeing right now, including the branch line on here. Everything underneath this pile. From this point currently over that way, is operational. It's just become a catch-all point. And the plastics, because due to a leak, I have to dress up on the roof. Thank heavens I was able to get replacement parts. I need to repair that. But to clarify what Vinny was asking in comments. The plan is to go from here over to where you see that piece of wood on top there. Along here, on uphill climb, around, come back around, and the main yard up through here, leveling off to about a foot, 6 inches down from where the roof is, and that's right where the roof's at. So probably about where that dot, those pluses are, all the way around to the other side of the layout. Along here. To another return loop. That way I can have a... Because hence why I want to do the following, guys. I want to put in a 45 piece here to here. Which of course I'll mean I'll have to do some reworking. Which I've been wanting to rework this for a couple years now. So I can have a Y feature here. Considering I've already got an extra MRC reverse module. But, excuse me, I've only been up since 5 a.m. And it is currently 8 a.m. now. But I want to put in a switch somewhere back in here. Curve off and lead over here. Because I already have a spur. I don't know how... Well, it's not going to be very visible way at the moment because of the catch-all problem. But right where that switch is, I got a double slip and it might pop in its location. That way I can just spin the train right on back around and pack out the main up to the upper level. Or if I want to let it gain some mileage, it can stay on the main loop. Is this still connected as a concentric loop? But that's just one of the ideas I have. Anyway, Southern 207 out.